niche at the time was, let's kick out all the cars, make the pedestrian mall, and that'll get people back from the big shopping malls. Statistics show that about 11% have been successful. And you'll find that most of those are either in southern states, college towns, certainly not Ohio weather in February. Now, I'm not new to this study either. It's been talked about for years and years. You know, Sue Truby's here in the previous administration. We've talked about this for a long time. Never really came to the table because we had a lot of cool things going on in town. And I think it's time now to take a look. It's time to realize what it could be, what the different options are. And I'll tell you why the time is right. We can refurbish everything the way it is now and spend a ton of money, and it's not going to look much different other than you might not trip and twist your ankle when you leave here. We can do that. But if we're going to spend money, let's do a study and see what it could be. What are the possibilities?
The planning for this project, the public meetings like this, sharing information with you all, as well as urban design and landscape architecture. We've teamed up with a firm called EMHT. There are traffic consultants on this project. So as we start to look at how these downtown streets work and how changes may impact that, they will be doing a lot of analysis. They're actually out there right now doing traffic counts. So if you've noticed any weird things in the roadway, that's them doing traffic counts. So we are very informed with how traffic is functioning today. We'll also be working with regional planning organizations to do a traffic model to look out 20, 30 years in the future and see how traffic may change and how this project will fit with that. So we're not just looking at a snapshot of time today, we'll be looking at a larger vision, a larger time horizon.